Hello students, now I am going to talk about this bilinear transformation. Some of the examples I am going to solve here under the module, under the concept complex analysis, probability and statistical methods. So already I explained about this bilinear transformation. So here directly we can go for using the equation of the bilinear transformation W equals to AZ plus B divided by CZ plus D. That is one method, and with the help of cross ratio equation also we can find the solution of this bilinear transformation. Here I am going to use the equation of the cross ratio. One example already I did. Now some of the problems I am going to discuss here. The next problem here, the first problem is find the bilinear transformation that maps the points 1i minus 1 onto the points i 0 minus 1. So here set of z value, set of w value they given. With the help of this we have to find out the equation of the bilinear transformation. The set of z value and w value, first we have to name it. Z1 is 1, z2 is I, z3 is minus 1. Similarly, w1 is I, w2 is 0, w3 is minus I. And we should write the equation of the cross ratio as W minus W1, W2 minus W3 in the denominator, W1 minus W2, W3 minus W. Similarly, in the RHS side, Z minus Z1, Z2 minus Z3 divided by Z1 minus Z2 into Z3 minus Z. The given set of values of Z and also W, it means Z1, Z2, Z3 and W1, W2, W3. These values we have to substitute in the equation of the cross ratio. After substituting, equation can be written as W minus I, 0 plus I, denominator I minus 0, minus I minus W. Similarly, in the RHS part, Z minus 1, I plus 1, denominator I minus I, minus 1 minus Z. Now, we have to do the simplification for this equation. W minus I, write as it is, 0 plus I will become I, denominator I minus 0 will become I, and we can take negative outside, means the next term will become W plus I. Similarly, in the RHS part, Z minus 1, I plus 1, you just write as it is. And denominator 1 minus I, and the next term, if I take a negative term as outside, means 1 plus Z. Here, both the side, the negative term will get cancelled. And also, numerator, denominator, I term will get cancelled in the LHS part. So that will become W minus I by W plus I. Similarly, in the LHS side, I think here no changes. You can write that one as it is. Only the negative term will get cancelled. Z minus 1, I plus 1 divided by 1 minus I into 1 plus Z. In the next step, we have to do the cross multiplication. On cross multiplication, W minus I can be written as 1, that into 1 minus I, 1 plus Z, which is equals to W plus I, Z minus 1, I plus 1. Now, both LHS and RHS, 3 factors are there. That 3 factors we have to multiply and we have to do the simplification. Some of the terms will get cancelled. After simplification of that, we can write the given equation as 2W minus 2WZI, which is equals to 2ZI plus 2. Now, here if I taken 2W as common means 1 minus ZI, and here 2 if I taken as common means 1 plus ZI. Here, my intention is what? We have to find out the value of W in terms of Z. So, W you just keep there. 2, 2 term will get cancelled. So, W can be written as Iz plus 1 divided by minus Iz plus 1. This is what our required bilinear transformation. For this first example. Now, we'll go for solve one more example in this bilinear transformation. Find the bilinear transformation that maps the points 1i minus 1 onto the points 2i minus 2. Also, find the invariant points. Whereas in a first example, they asked us to find out only the bilinear transformation. They given set of Z value and also W value. Whereas in the second example, here also they asked us to find out bilinear transformation. Given data is set of Z value and set of W value. Along with that, we have to find out the invariant points. Invariant points means fixed point. That also we have to find out. Okay, invariant point we can find out later. First, we have to find out bilinear transformation. We should write the equation of the cross ratio W minus W1, W2 minus W3 by W1 minus W2, W3 minus W, which is equals to Z minus Z1, Z2 minus Z3 by Z1 minus Z2, Z3 minus Z. In this equation, we have to substitute the given set of Z1, Z2, Z3 and W1, W2, W3 values we have to substitute. After that, we have to do the simplification. Here, W minus 2, I plus 2, write as it is. And in a denominator, W plus 2, if I take a negative term as outside. Next, Z minus 1, I plus 1, denominator also 1 minus I write as it is. You just take negative outside, that will becomes 1 plus Z. Both the side, that negative term will get cancelled. After that, we'll go for conjugation of this. Or else, take W minus 2, W plus 2, you just keep that term there only. You just do the cross multiplication for the next terms, I plus 2 and 2 minus I. You just take to RHS part. After that, you just do the simplification, you just multiply. So, on simplification, you can write the equation as like this. W minus 2 by W plus 2, you can get the equation as Z minus 1 by Z plus 1 into I plus 3 by 3 minus I. Now, once again, you just do the cross multiplication. So, after doing cross multiplication, we have to multiply 3 factors. So, after multiplication, some of the terms will get cancelled and rest of the term can be written as 6W minus 2WZI, which is equals to 12Z minus 4I. Here, 2W if I taken as common means 3 minus ZI, which is equals to 2 into 6Z minus 2I. So, on simplification, this can be written as W equals to 6Z minus 2I divided by minus IZ plus 3. This is what our required bilinear transformation. So, in a question, they asked us to find out invariant points or else fixed points. So, by definition itself, I told in a obtained bilinear transformation, we have to replace W as Z. After that, we have to do the simplification. We will get one quadratic equation. That one we have to solve. So, here also the same thing. In a obtained bilinear transformation, you just replace W as Z. So, equation can be written as Z equals to 6Z minus 2I divided by minus IZ plus 3. You just do the cross multiplication. On simplification, you will get one quadratic equation. So now we have to solve this quadratic equation with the help of formula x equals to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. With the help of that, we can get the roots as like this. Z equals to 3 plus or minus 1 by minus 2i. 1 root is 4 by minus 2i and one more root is 2 by minus 2i. On simplification, we can write thus roots are 2i and then i. These two are the required invariant points or fixed points. Thank you.